Are you familiar with the word insta-famous? Insta-famous. Yeah, it's the term for someone who has blown up or gone viral on, like, Instagram or Twitter or Pinterest or Facebook or YouTube, and they just had that one sensational moment that everybody in the world suddenly knows them. Maybe you remember the Chewbacca mask. And you have to ask yourself the question, oh my gosh, what is the magic formula? What is the secret sauce that makes Insta-famous happen? And how do I apply it to me? I'm J. Loren Norris with Leading Leaders Podcast, and I'm going to tell you one of the most powerful words I've heard in the last probably 5 years. It's actually two words together. It's a tough one. You ready? Write this down. Obedient obscurity. Obedient obscurity. Now, while you're writing that down, you may think, well, where in the world do I find a definition for that? And if I just look it up on YouTube or Google, what will I find? You'll probably not find it at all, because I think, aside from the book that I read it in, you probably won't see it anywhere. It's a tough subject. The book is called Divine Detours by Cyan Alfred. And I'll try to remember to put that in the link below. But Divine Detours by Cyan Alfred. And there's a chapter in there where he talks about obedient obscurity. You see, there are two challenges that I see in the world of leadership today. And I don't just mean in leadership. I mean, there's a webinar at every corner for every subject. You want to learn how to crochet? There's a webinar for that. You want to learn how to get your dog to do his business when you take him outside every day? There's a webinar for that. You want to learn how to build a platform to reach 10 million people in 24 hours for 18 cents? There's a webinar for that. Grow your church, build your business, hire new employees, get people to volunteer to do the work you don't want to do. There's a webinar for that. But see, here's the challenge for me when celebrities, and I don't use this in air quotes to say they're not real celebrities. I say these are celebrities in a given field. Maybe they're the best golfer, the best basketball player, the best football player. But see, I wouldn't necessarily want to take financial advice from Tom Brady. Yes, he's a Super Bowl MVP, but I'd be willing to bet that all the money that he manages, he pays someone to manage. I don't want him to give me advice on finances. I want somebody who handles money every day to give me advice on finances. And I want it to be someone whose heart and calling is about money. Maybe a Gunnar Johnson or someone like that. That I could say, he's studied his whole life. He's been up and down and through the valley and through the mill to learn finances. That's the guy I want to hear from finances about, not just the guy who has a big giant platform because at one time he was a professional sports player. But see, here's the other side of the same coin. The idea that because you have celebrity status, you can speak on anything from politics to faith to shoelaces to underwater basket weaving and crochet because you have a platform, that concerns me. And here's why. A, we may be trusting people who have a large voice because of the size of their platform, because of their celebrity, because of their notoriety, but they have no expertise or experience in the field they want to talk about. They just, they're fascinated with it. The other side of that same coin is there are a lot of people out there who are experts in their field. But rather than being loyal to their field, being dedicated to the people who need to hear the message that they have to deliver, the people whose lives could be at peril if they don't hear what this expert has to say. Instead, the expert is busy chasing the celebrity train, trying to get on every television show and every YouTube interview and every podcast and every opportunity for notoriety, and they've lost the passion for the message that they're called to deliver. They've lost the passion for the audience. They were sent here to serve. And instead, they find themselves looking for the spotlight, running from here to there to over yonder to get in a spotlight that's already shining, to get on the stage with someone who has celebrity status, to have a chance to build themselves up. Stop it. Focus on that obedient obscurity. Spend time developing your message for the people that you're called to love. And if you're going to spend time and money on marketing and promotion, promote your message. Promote the help that you offer. Promote the solution that you provide. Promote it to the people that you're called to serve, the people you're called to love. Don't spend your time and money becoming a celebrity so that people will know you can help them. Get busy helping people, and your message will become a celebrity on its own. I'm J. Loren Norris with Leading Leaders Podcast for Tell It Like It Is TV. Have a blessed day.